Hello, this is a look back at the LEGO Collectible Minifigures Series 7 full collection from the year 2012. I'm just going to go through these one by one in the order that they appear on the collection sheet that would be included with each of the figures. First up is the swimming champion here, who came with that gold metal to go around her neck, and of course that will work with any minifigure. Also has the tight-fitting black swimming cap, which has some wrinkles in it, which look pretty appropriate. I really like the facial expression on this one, actually, because it's very serious, you know, happy, satisfied with her life, but serious about what she's doing. So she's not celebrating her achievement here. She's just, you know, showing that she is really into what she does. She works really hard, and I guess that's why she won the championship in the first place. Around the back, no printing on the torso there, but there is a surprise under the cap. Does have a face where she is happy, as she should be, for earning the gold medal. Next up is the Aztec Warrior, a very ornate figure, very ornate, with the printing on the torso, the printing on the legs as well, that's really nice, and also on the shield. And then, getting beyond those things, look at the printing on that very ornate headdress. Wow, they got all the little small paint applications around the tips of the feathers. That goes on both sides. They got some pretty nice crisp detailing in the eye there. You know, not multiple colors. I mean, it's two colors, I guess, you know, the black and the blue, but you know, it's just nice. It's well done. I'm not a big fan of this particular version of gold color that LEGO makes, but I think it actually works out pretty well with this figure. Maybe except for the spear. I think that a two-tone spear would have looked a little bit better. Not much more to be seen in that head there. Just a little more of the kind of teal color that wasn't shown, and there's no alternate face here. Bunny suit guy here is one of those pretty much universally liked minifigures in a costume. They did this one with a completely open face, which just shows the guy's face, you know, just straight on, didn't try to put any sort of decoration across the front. I think that works out just fine because he does have that very cheery face, and it does come with this carrot, which looks extra large until you consider how it looks next to regular minifigures, and that's just the size that it always is. But I think it actually goes really well with the comic size with this sort of costume, and there's nothing else to be seen for prints, no alternate face. The bride is a theme that LEGO has explored a number of times through its history, and I think that this is one of the better looking ones. Really nice printing on the torso with some metallic silver, as you can see. A very bright smile, she's very, very happy. And the nice flower piece, a flower stock piece that fits in the hand like that. A good veil as well. This is a very soft piece, very soft cloth piece. It's just a little bit see-through, just a little bit translucent. Works very nicely. Has the tiara up on top, done in silver there, and there's no print to be seen on the back whatsoever. Also a nice hairpiece. I really feel like this one could have used a secondary face though, a Bridezilla face. Here's the Ocean King with his trident, and there you can see the distinct difference between two of the gold colors that LEGO has used in recent years. I very much prefer the one that's used up here. And I also very much like that headpiece. It's also well detailed. I like the spiraling shapes around the front. And you know, it's just a single white piece, so they actually did print at that time. They just painted on the gold color on top of it. And there's some pretty decent scale printing on the front of the leg part. A lot to be seen underneath. See, you take just the beard off and then you can see a lot more of the print for that torso, and also his face a lot more clearly. It's a very, very stern face and looks very different with no facial hair on it. The bagpipe guy, I think, is exceptionally well done. There's a lot of good stuff done here with the printing on the bagpipe itself, which is a very nice mold. As you can see, it can be held in the hands properly with two hands with these figures, and the print goes around a very curved surface. The face on this one is very similar to the Ocean King one, not the same, doesn't have as many lines on it. The kilt is well printed, it's just a little bit faded in its colors, which I think is appropriate. I'm glad that they didn't go super dark with the red color. And then there's also printing for the entire hat, and across the entire top, including the center. I don't know the name of that offhand, but see, there's just a lot that is applied to this figure. Taking the bagpipe out of his hands as well, pretty respectable printing for the torso, and believe it or not, there's actually printing on the legs. I guess you're not supposed to see most of that, but it's there. This is the Daredevil. He's, I'd say, a late 1970s Evel Knievel wannabe. Has the funny hair done in the medium nougat color. There's actually no print on the back of this whatsoever. Just a plain cape piece done in white. But they do give you one alternate thing that you can do, which is important. It made sense. You can swap out the helmet. And the helmet that he comes with has the nice blue visor, which of course can be raised and lowered as always, but it also has his own print with the star. And that's pretty cool. I think that that's a usable collectible piece in its own right. The official name of this character is Galaxy Patrol, so I'm assuming he's supposed to be some sort of galactic policeman. One in a long line of figures like this. I think this one looks pretty good and a little bit distinct with the dark blue main color. He looks very serious. Nice printing on the shoulders. This backpack and armor piece has a couple of attachment points for clips and then one. Well, you could also stick a bar in the center there, or you could just attach anything that's, you know, got an anti-stud on the underside. And there's definitely more to be seen as you take some of this stuff off. See lots more print on the torso that most of the time is just completely hidden, squandered away, useless. You're not able to appreciate it. This is cool. Alternate face. It's especially important to see that from the front, both without the helmet, so you could see this as being just one of his looks, you know, he's actually bald, or with the helmet, so you see how the eyepiece kind of integrates in. If I can ever get it on, there we go. Integrates in and comes out from the side. That's actually a good look. Now, I can't tell if the tennis ace here is just struggling to keep a volley going or if he is angry because he's saying, that was out. That was out. I don't know. You can kind of see it whichever way, depending upon how you want to imagine this particular player. No print whatsoever on the back. It just looks so plain from the back. That's too bad. I wish there was something just to distinguish it, because from the front, you know, obviously you can see that he's wearing shorts, but they didn't bring anything around the back from any of the green color from the bottom half or the top half. I would have liked to see just, you know, just a stripe, that lower stripe from the t-shirt or something going around back there. This is the Jungle Boy. It was a fairly straightforward, you know, primitive guy figure. He's got his necklace, which I would assume that he has made himself. It looks like it's made with some canine teeth. And then there is a scar, a fairly fresh scar, on his chest from a battle with some sort of wild animal. Also missing just a little bit of hair from one of his eyebrows, so I'm assuming that represents a scar as well. But I think the highlight of this figure is the inclusion of the small chimpanzee that can be grabbed from the arm like that. Also has an anti-stud on the underside. It's not poseable at all, it's just one single piece. It's molded in black and then they added the rest on top of that, but I think it's a cool thing and a very collectible one at that. This one also gets no print on the back, but at least there's some color that comes through the hip piece and there's nothing to be seen for an alternate face. LEGO calls this figure hippie. Straight up, hippie. They didn't try to come up with anything like peaceful guy, or no, just hippie. That's the official name of the character. So no pulling punches on that one. The hairpiece on this one is funny. I'm glad that they got the color into the hairband. That's done pretty well. And look at this. He's got print on an arm here. That's good. He's got that same flower stalk piece with just different color flowers that we just saw on the bride recently. Printing on that arm there, and very nice printing for the torso. I actually really like this torso print. There we go. And you can see his face a little bit better like that as well. But yes, it's, you know, it's nice and colorful, and I feel like it's useful for some other things. I guess he's got a natural leather jacket, like a vest jacket thing on, and a tie-dye shirt underneath that. Next up is the computer programmer. I really like the torso that comes with this one because you could use it for a good Mr. Rogers or a Bill Nye the Science Guy. I think they were kind of channeling Bill Nye the Science Guy with this one a bit. I'm not sure. I don't think they needed to go with the tape around the center of the glasses. That's just a little bit too cliche because, you know, it's not that young and nerdy. I think that this is more of a serious professional. And, you know, this is just how he dresses. I think that he would have a little bit more, well, two things. One, pride, and two, money from the work that he does. And he would be able to get new glass frames. My favorite thing here is the C prompt on the mug. It's an exclusive printed piece, and I just really connect with that because I was brought up on computers myself and spent way too much time looking at a C prompt just like that. He also comes with, or came with, a laptop piece. I'm getting that open for you. I'm guessing it was an HP. It's just a dark bluish gray laptop, you know, the normal one, but good to get. And also a cool hairpiece on this one. I'm not sure if that was the first time it was used, but it's been used quite a bit since. Next up is the Viking woman, complete with Hollywood stereotype horned helmet there. Probably not necessarily historically accurate, but that's okay. We get what they were going for. It is just a toy. It is just a caricature. The shield here, I think, is very intentionally plain, just a plain wooden buckler is all it is. You know, just lightweight, quick and dirty, does the job. Good printing on this one, even though it's not too intricate from top to bottom, but the parts that are there are done nicely, like the belt, this detailing around here, and also the necklaces. And I think these are little fastening devices. I don't know what you call it. It's some sort of pin or buckle themselves, the small round gold parts. But yeah, pretty nicely done. And then the hairpiece extends around pretty well, but that is all molded together. So it's all molded in tan, and then they just paint on the silver over that. And then the white horns themselves are just regular horn pieces that you just insert. This was 2012's generic Evil Knight figure, and it looks like he represents a group called the Boars, I would say, something like that. Very very high contrast printing on this one. A lot of repetition, not a lot of really small detail, but I'm fine with it. It looked good for what it is, you know, something completely fantasy based. Now this one does not have any print on the torso whatsoever, which I think makes total sense, because why bother printing the torso when you're just gonna cover the whole thing up with armor? I think that makes total sense, but they did still get some printing into the hip piece. You can see right through there. Let me take this helmet off so you can see the rest of his face. Yeah, there is a fair amount more to see there. It definitely looks like he's possessed by some sort of demon or evil sorcerer, right? He's not just a regular guy who happens to be fighting for the bad guys. There's something more going on. The Rocker Girl was and is a very distinct figure, and I think it will remain very recognizable through the ages. They did very well on the print on the legs for this one, I think. I think they did print the front and sides separately because the lines don't line up perfectly, but the black is just continuous from front to back, so that's good. See, just a little bit of gap with the yellow, not so much over here. But those legs are all white, as you can see from the back here, but medium azure paint and medium azure color for the torso. No print on the back of the torso. Nice guitar here, little period piece that could be used, you know, on different figures to create slightly different looks. Pretty respectable printing on the torso itself as well. And the hairpiece was a really cool thing used on, was it only two figures so far? Maybe more than that. I can only think of two myself. But the face is a lot more distinct than you can see with the hairpiece on. So she's got a little bit of face painting on there and some pretty distinct and very noticeable, more noticeable than usual, eye and lip makeup. This last one is mostly interesting to me in its name and how generic they went with it. obviously, this is Little Red Riding Hood, but they don't go with, you know, recognizable names of characters or most historical figures. They'll change them out. This one was called Grandma Visitor. That's the official name of the character, and I just think that's funny in several different ways, and I like it. I get it, and I like it. Grandma Visitor. Only Lego. Not a lot really going on with this figure, to be honest with you. It's just the print on the torso, which, you know, it's okay. It's not particularly great. A small cape to go with the short-legged figure, and the young girl headpiece there. Also comes with the basket, and that's just it. And that's the last figure in this series. But I think it's pretty cool. So, out of these 16 figures, which is your personal favorite? I'm gonna go with the Bagpiper myself. I just think it's a really well done figure with so much printing, so much attention to detail. It just feels like it goes above and beyond the norm and really what's needed for a figure to be successful and valuable. Probably tied for second place for me would be the Bride, which is well done as well, and the Computer Programmer, which just comes with parts that I like. Those are just my choices though. Please do share your choices and comments down below, and I'll talk to you again soon. Thanks for watching.